Netflix this week reported that it lost about a million subscribers last quarter and would gain about a million subscribers this quarter, with competitors catching up and the stock trading at less than half of where it was. Can the streaming pioneer reinvent itself? John Ford is here to weigh in. What do you think, John?
No. Netflix can't just reinvent itself. It's funny. 364 days ago, I was here arguing whether the company was over the hill, and a one-year chart of the company looks like that hill. Here's the problem with Netflix. It was built for the a la carte dream. The idea that technology had birthed an era when the broadband-connected home TV would be the ultimate global entertainment device, and Netflix's algorithm would make both movie theaters and advertising obsolete. The movies would be so great we would be content to subscribe and watch them at home. The TV shows would be so brilliant that we would pay to see them commercial-free. Well, the a la carte dream failed. Turns out leaving the house and going to see a movie, to see Top Gun Maverick, it's a feature, not a bug. It's pretty great sometimes. And there are millions of people who are either sharing passwords or turning off Netflix after binging Stranger Things. They'd rather watch ads than pay the full fee. But Netflix can just stick ads in the shows now. Simple, right? Well, wrong. Netflix execs didn't plan for this scenario. They didn't get the rights to put ads in all of the content they carry, which is why the Wall Street Journal reports they're going to amend deals with studios like Sony, Universal, and Warner Brothers. They're trying to anyway. The studios are wiser now, though, and aren't going to give up those rights easily. In other words, it's going to be expensive for Netflix to make itself cheaper. The model doesn't work, Becky.
All right, that may be the case, but Netflix still has a nearly $100 billion market capitalization. It's got a trailblazing reputation in Hollywood, so it might be hard, but can't this company pivot?
Well, Becky, on the other hand, this is the company that was just mailing DVDs 15 years ago before it invented modern streaming services. Of course, Netflix can reinvent itself. Why? Well, Netflix has the biggest global subscriber base at more than 220 million. It's got a sterling creative reputation, which gives access to the top talent. Its brand stands at the intersection of media and software, and it's a technologically ambitious company born in Silicon Valley that's more likely than its competitors to innovate its way out of a slump. So Netflix was late to realize it was over-reliant on the subscription model. But the company is hinting that it's approaching advertising in an innovative way that's going to jump ahead of the competition. They're working with Microsoft because they want to build something new. And if they get this right, advertising won't just be in the cheapest plans. It'll be in most plans. And eventually, subscribers will have to pay more than they do now to completely eliminate ads. Okay, and about Netflix renegotiating studio deals to allow advertising. Yes, it's a pain, but it's not a major issue. Netflix execs said this week that they could launch a good ad-back service today without renegotiating anything, and they're not going to overpay for rights. Rough as the stock action is, Netflix's biggest hit seasons ever have all come out in the past 12 months, and that's the best position to stage a reinvention, Becky.
How different can you actually make ads look? What are you expecting?
I think you can do things pretty differently with interactivity in ads on a platform that you completely control. And with the scale of accounts that Netflix has and with all of the back history and data and what people have watched and are interested in watching, that's pretty rich. So I expect
they
could
come up. It's going to look like ads on Instagram or you know, some of the things that you try and get me to click through on. That's assuming that I'm going to want to engage.
It is assuming you're going to want to engage, but think about how they can make a song from the 80s through Stranger Things hit the top of the charts again. How much would Spotify pay, right, to have a direct link into people going from hearing that song to subscribing to Spotify? That's probably worth a lot of money.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.